What's up and welcome back to another Kind of Funny live reaction to a trailer. It has been quite a while. We've done a Kind of Funny
Go wide again, Barry. Go wide. Get all this. You got to show the audience the one thing didn't go off, the one never stopped.
the smoke machines are just excited. They're haunted. We reacted to a trailer because it's been a very long time since we've been able to do this. We've been busy. It just hasn't fit schedules, even though a lot of trailers have been dropping. So, of course, we had to make an exception for Ghostbusters Tropical Freeze.
Nope.
Ghostbusters Frozen Empire. Yes, Frozen Kingdom. I was about to say, I messed it up.
Yeah, I can see that too. Yeah. I can understand. It's brand new. You're just trying it on. It's on the tongue for the first time. Don't worry about
it. And it's bizarre, right? Like, we obviously haven't seen this trailer yet. Let's get into this. I'm Tim Gettys, of course. Hi. This is Greg Miller. That's Nick Scarpino. We're about to react to this trailer, and it's great. You can get this on youtube.com/kindoffunny, where we react to all the latest trailers. You can subscribe to the Screencast podcast feed for our weekly reactions to different TV shows, and our in-review feed for a bunch of ranking, reviewing, and recapping movies like The Marvels that is going to be coming out this Friday, and then Loki Season 2 will be added to MCU in review, featuring me, Greg, Nick, and Andy, giving all our thoughts on all of that. So that's really exciting. But yeah, Ghostbusters, I'm going to keep saying Tropical Freeze. Frozen Empire.
Yeah.
What's up with that?
We're about to find out.
Yeah?
Yeah. Like, I mean, there's been rumors, and I've seen backstage stuff, and I obviously the poster with the ice on it. We knew we were going with the ice theme, and then the name got leaked, yada, yada, yada. We're about to find out. I don't know what is going on with it yet, because I haven't watched the trailer. I wanted to make sure I watched it with you, fine gentlemen, to begin with.
Yeah.
My excitement for it is high. Obviously, another Ghostbusters film. Who would have thought? You know what I mean? I never thought I'd get Afterlife, let alone a sequel to Afterlife.
Sure.
And I'm the world's biggest Ghostbusters fan, if you didn't know. Sorry, everybody. You know, I'm excited to see what they do with it. And I would assume, obviously, based on everything of the title and everything else, we're just hopefully, right? Let's just get away from Gozer. Right? That was always my thing where it's like, if you want to sit there and take it from the big picture, right, of like Ghostbusters with me, right? Think about it this way. Stick with me. You've had four in-universe pictures / games. I'm tossing Ghostbusters the video game in there. Of those four projects, three of them were about Gozer and Zool and all. It's like, when I think of Ghostbusters, and granted, because the way I was raised and the time period I was raised, real Ghostbusters, you know, reading comic books about Ghostbusters, even as an adult, whatever. To me, Ghostbusters and the mythos is way more interesting of just like, yeah, we go and bust ghosts. You know what I mean? It doesn't need to always be fucking back to what's going on with Gozer, right? And so like Afterlife obviously being what it was and being, hey, we're, you know, pulling the Star Wars move and we're going to go back to what people know and do all these different things. I thought they did a nice twist on it, but I'm happy it's over, period. I'm hoping when we start this trailer, it is not Gozer's back and now she's cold. You know what I mean? Like, what is it? Who are we going? Now, of course,
she's wearing a jacket.
I say all that, right? And it's like, well, you know, Ghostbusters 2 had Vigo and like people did not like Ghostbusters 2 for the most part, right? But it's also like, well, Ghostbusters 2 was a direct reaction to the real Ghostbusters and kids are gonna buy all this stuff, make it kitty, make new packs, make them slime stuff.
There's just something about it. And again, when Donkey Kong Country Returns came out and then they announced Tropical Freeze, I was like, and again, Tropical Freeze is one of my favorite games of all time once it came out, but weird choice for like a theme where it's we're just gonna just do ice levels, and it's like, I don't know that people want that. And for Ghostbusters, I'm like, I'm with you of like, hey, it's something different, but without
not where you'd go, right?
Just the name, I'm like, this just seems very, very bizarre. What do you think, Nick?
I don't think it's bizarre. I think that's just the era we're in right now, right? Long gone are the sequels where it's like 1, 2, 3, and 4. We have to have distinction, and once Afterlife came out, I think that kind of broke it open. It does sound very generic, which I think is what you're reacting to. So my first reaction,
I would say even as the biggest Ghostbusters fan any of you know, and I'm talking about you watching, right? When I saw the poster and it was just the logo in ice, I was like,
It reminds me.
I'm not like hyped for that. Like, I'm excited Ghostbusters about
it. Up until this point, it was usually the kiss of death when you hit like Mummy 3 and you had to have the sub headline where it was just completely unrecognizable and completely unmemorable. But I mean, Afterlife did sort of reboot the franchise. So I'm excited to see who's coming back, what the general vibe is. And to Greg's point, I'm hoping that this is a step forward in building the broader Ghostbusters universe, because they are kind of pigeonholed like Star Wars right now.
The excitement.
It is the Emperor. It is Gozer. It is just this narrow little story where it doesn't have to be.
You figure part of my excitement is, of course, back to like all the leaks and the rumors were, I mean, it was codenamed Firehouse, right? And of course, McKenna had done a TikTok where she was like on the set they built in the UK, and she came to the fire pole and came out of the firehouse. And it's like the idea of like, cool, you know, the Spangler family from Afterlife is now living in the firehouse. And what is that like to be thrown into a new city, into New York? How is New York reacting to the Ghostbusters? Yeah. I'm hoping the movie has at least a first act of that, of like, yeah, we're the Ghostbusters and we're doing random ass things and people don't believe us, but we're here in New York. And then whatever the giant, big, bad, cold guy is.
He's going to be so cold, Nick.
You think it's going to be Arnold Schwarzenegger from Batman and Robin?
The Ice Age!
The Ice Age!
We can only hope. We're about to get right into this trailer. Remember, you go to Patreon.com.
Right into it. How long have we talked?
Kind of funny to get the show ad-free for everyone else. You get some ads later. But Barrett, without further ado, please.
Can we get the full screen instead of picture-in-picture? Is that impossible? Thank you. What a man.
A little Cruel Summer. Not even a redo. It's just old-school Cruel Summer. Another hot one out
there. In fact, there are heat alerts in effect for New Jersey, feeling like 100 degrees.
So far, I'm vibing. Put Phoebe on the beach with a little PKE meter. Let's fucking go.
Time in New York history, people froze to death in the middle of July.
What is it?
The death nail. The power to kill by fear itself. Your veins turn to rivers of ice. Your bones crack. And the last thing you see is your own tear ducts freezing up.
Like, literally scared to death?
So cool.
Oh, you motherfuckers know I'm buying that jacket.
Yeah, that jacket. Where's
the pre-order link on the jacket? Let's go. Let's fucking go. I need that jacket now.
I love it, guys. I love how I was like, whatever, this looks fine. This looks fine. Then there's the jackets at the end. I'm like, you got me. That's awesome.
You know, I'm good. Halloween 2024. Going to be sweating his ass off walking around the studio in that thing.
Oh, my God. That is so funny. Oh, my God. Hold on. So we're gonna go to ads real quick. I want to give a shout out to Patreon producers, of course, Nathan Lamoth, James Hastings, and Casey Andrew. They're not gonna have to hear this ad, but everyone else, here it is. This episode is brought to you by Shady Rays. Tis the season of giving. Get the perfect gift for a special someone, yourself, or both. Our friends at Shady Rays have you covered with premium polarized shades and quick swap snow goggles that won't break the bank. Shady Rays is an independent sunglasses company that offers an unrivaled product that's just as good as any expensive pair we've worn. Y'all know I've been outside in the sun a lot playing Pokemon Go, and it's such a great experience wearing Shady Rays when I'm out and about looking dope. And that's not all. Every pair of sunglasses is backed by lost or broken replacements. If you lose or break your pair, even on day one, they told us they will send you a brand new pair, no questions asked. Exclusively for our listeners, Shady Rays is giving out a very merry deal for the season. You can go to shadyrays.com, use code KINDOFUNNY for 50% off 2+ pairs of polarized sunglasses. Try for yourself the shades rated 5 stars by over 250,000 people by going to shadyrays.com, using code KINDOFUNNY, and you'll get 50% off 2 or more pairs of polarized sunglasses. This episode's brought to you by Rocket Money. Rocket Money is a personal finance app that finds and cancels your unwanted subscriptions. It monitors your spending and helps you lower your bills all in one place, and it has surprised multiple of my friends and people are kind of funny at how many subscriptions they have that they have forgot they're still paying for. Over 80% of people have subscriptions they've forgotten about. Seriously, think of how many free trials you've subscribed to that you've probably never canceled. That's why I'm such a big fan of Rocket Money. It's so easy to cancel the ones you don't want with just the press of a button. Rocket Money can even negotiate to lower your bills for you by up to 20%. All you have to do is take a picture of your bill and Rocket Money takes care of the rest. Rocket Money is a personal finance app that finds and cancels your unwanted subscriptions, monitors your spending, and helps you lower your bills all in one place. Stop wasting money on things you don't use. Cancel your unwanted subscriptions and manage your money the easy way by going to rocketmoney.com/kindoffunny. That's rocketmoney.com/kindoffunny. rocketmoney.com/kindoffunny.
Jack is hot as fuck. All right. You kidding me right now? Shake up the cosplay. Let's go.
You literally can put a Ghostbusters logo on anything and you would be so excited about it.
Yeah.
Put it on an old ham sandwich. You'd be like, that's the best sandwich ever made.
I fucking cried watching Star Wars Force Awakens trailer. So shut up and let me enjoy this.
Everyone
all right?
did. Tim told me to do it for the TikTok.
Oh my God. We didn't even have TikTok. I think it was still Musically lit back then.
No, I appreciate just the commitment to like the new outfits. You know what I mean? Because like Ghostbusters 2 outfit always been my favorite.
It's a great outfit.
That the darker tone, yeah, you know, yeah, what I mean. Yeah. I love that with the name as dumb as Frozen Kingdom, and now I can say it's dumb. At least they're committing to it. At least they're going all the way through of like this. Just this feels like I don't even know. We're now in the toy aisle that's like the clearance aisle.
Would you feel better if it was called Ghostbusters Frozen Empire? You said kingdom again.
God damn,
if you're gonna hate it, you gotta hate it for the right thing. Okay, just making sure. Gotta make sure.
What do you think of this, Greg?
You know, it does what it's supposed to do. For me, a Ghostbusters fan, I'm excited for this. I think at a glance, right? Like we don't come away with any, you know, super knowledge of the movie or whatever. But again, it's what I was asking for before we started, right? Like, let's not do Gozer. Let's not do Evo Shandor. Let's do something different. And honestly, watching it gives me a lot of vibes of real Ghostbusters, which could totally be a turnoff for other people or whatever. But like, I'm down to see some fucking weird ghost do this. What is, you know, what's the description going to be? I knew Patton Oswalt. I've known Kumail's in it. I knew Patton Oswalt was in it. Them at their glimpse there, you know, with doing the exposition with Rey. I love that idea of them being, you know, probably going through Tobin's spirit guide, talking about what this is, what's going on for it or whatever. I don't think this CG looks great. I don't look at these ice shards coming out of the ground and go, oh, they look so realistic. But then again, the way it's being shot in general, I'm not like, oh, the whole movie looks super realistic. But it's like, I don't know.
That's what you said. I actually think the CG looks pretty well.
Like, I look at this and I'm like, oh, well, this isn't like happening in the real streets of New York, but I think it fits for what they're doing from what I'm seeing from the trailer, right? Or whatever of it. This is what I've always wanted from Ghostbusters in terms of the series and whatever of, hey, we are going to give you other ghosts they are fighting and what's going on and where the shenanigans are and stuff like that. So I'm happy to see him back. It made me pop for that. You know, it definitely, as it, we knew, obviously, in feels, reads just as a straight sequel to Afterlife, right? Where it looks like everybody's just picking right up from where we left off. That looks cool, whatever that ghost is plugging shit into his head. I like that. Secret rooms or whatever. This seems like a nice little setup. What I appreciate, again, and I know this is always a kiss of death with a lot of us in the Comic-Con old men stuff, like crowd, like, I watch this, and it really does make me go, I can't wait for Ben to see this. Like, sure. When he's old enough to understand it. This strikes me as, hey, this is a kid's Ghostbusters movie, which I'm totally down for and fine with. You know what I mean? Like, I love the idea of the kids being the Ghostbusters and them being the driving force and doing the thing and Lucky getting scared there and her eyes starting to freeze up. Like, that's all cool. Like, I like that idea a lot. This is a nice visual again, too, where it's just like, I feel like, granted, you know, there's only so few Ghostbusters property, but I've seen the Firehouse enough. The Firehouse is a character. Ecto-1 is a character. Seeing them in a way I usually don't see them, you know, a Firehouse all iced over like that, that's cool. I've never seen that before. But again, the ghost speaks to me on a very much like a real Ghostbusters level of, here's this big bad that's doing stuff in New York and da-da-da-da.
Nick, what'd you think?
I think it's going to be geared more toward newer Ghostbusters fans, which I don't blame them for. I do think this has a look of a more modern superhero film, which to me is a little bit of a turnoff because I'm like, oh, we're going back to New York. I want it to be like a little bit more about the city, about them, about that startup business that the first one was. I don't think you're going to. I think this is going to be a ensemble cast. I think there's going to be a lot of time dedicated to the core cast from Afterlife, but you've got, you know, some pretty heavy hitters in here. And Patton Oswalt coming, yeah. you know, being a character. Dan Aykroyd coming back as a character. We saw Ernie Hudson.
Bill Murray. Andy Potts confirmed.
Andy Potts. So we've got a lot
Walter
of...
Walter Peck is back, ladies and gentlemen.
We got William Atherton.
Yep.
I just watched Real Genius last night. So that's a lot of characters to juggle. And my worry is that it's going to be sort of a similar to a lot of the other ensemble films with a lot of fanfare and a lot of old nostalgic nods. But for the most part, not spending too much time developing any one of them.
Mm-hmm. I can see that.
But, you know, I think this is just what a modern day Ghostbusters is. It's big. It's a big summer blockbuster. It's a, you know, spring blockbuster. you know, lots of crazy CG. Most of it probably won't read as real.
And Spice Runner 90 says this could be Shazam too if I squint my eyes. Fuck you and shut up.
Well, I mean,
But
I mean, the ice does give you that vibe, right? I mean, there's a level of the original Ghostbusters, and this is going to sound seriously stupid for saying it because it's a movie called Ghostbusters that was grounded.
Oh, 100%.
And I think that this we are just not grounded at all.
And that's
anymore.
We dial the clock back. Back to when I was having IGN conversations about the rumored Ghostbusters movie or whatever in like 2010, and I was always very adamant, don't do it. Yeah. Just don't do it. I don't want the CG fest, it's all on green, and da-da-da-da-da. And then we got Ghostbusters 2016, which my problems weren't the cast. I loved the idea of a new cast. I loved the idea of a new universe.
It was misdirected.
I loved the funny women they put in the roles. I did not like the fact that it was like, they didn't even step out. They did Ghostbusters again. They didn't change anything to it. Mm. They should have done stuff. And then the ghosts look stupid in the way the UCG I didn't like. Da, da, da. It's a different conversation. There's an interview up about it. I'm with you that, like, even for Afterlife, I think they were trying to play homage to 84, right? So it was, here's the Terror Dogs, here's Gozer, you know, the Muncher looks like Slimer, and yada, yada, yada. This one I'm beating, you know, the drum, I guess, on the same point, but it's a 2-minute trailer I'm talking about, right? This looks like the cartoon, even in the very end there of the major ghost coming in, right? That looks like how Sam Hain would enter in Ghostbusters, Real Ghostbusters. It looks like how Ghostbusters, Rise of the Ghost Lord, the VR game, promotes their big bad mm-hmm. ghost. There, like, again, this looks like a live action cartoon, which I think could work. I mean, if they do it, if they're committed to that vision, that's what they do. But it is going to be distinctly different than what an 80s fan is going to walk in expecting.
I think that's the hardest balance, because, like, yeah, looking at this, it's like, this does seem like a fun kids movie, and I do like the art direction of it. I feel like it's not the best looking thing I've ever seen, but, like, it works. I just feel like we're still caught in that trying to appease too many different groups, which means it's not fully going to appease everybody or anybody,
yeah.
you know, where, like, there's just so many characters even that we're seeing here. And I'm struggling to be like, who do I know and who do I not know? Like, I know mm-hmm. the OG people, but, like, how of the kids, I'm like, I recognize a couple of them. You said Lucky. I'm like, oh, who the fuck is Lucky? Is that yeah. just you just know that? Or
yeah, well, I mean, I watched a movie and reviewed it with you where there was a character named Lucky. This idiot, yeah.
gotcha,
fucking, this motherfucker Lucky? Hears two notes of a song in a movie we were watching last night. He's like, oh, it's this and it is. And if I can't remember, Lucky, she was the girl who worked.
Sorry
at,
for well, me.
She was the girl. I mean? She was the girl who worked at Spinners that Finn Wolfhard was into or whatever, right?
Okay,
and, like,
yeah,
took him up
yeah,
on the thing, and then she helped him at the end. Like, her dad was the sheriff.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. It's just it's rough because they're not memorable characters, and it's Finn Wolfhard. It's not, I don't know his character name.
I would have said Trevor, but I know you wouldn't have understood who that was.
But I think that, like, the kid stuff, like, it worked for me in the other movie, but I think that then compared to the other shit, it altogether didn't work.
My hope in my hope glancing at this trailer is that they're going to lean into that. That it really is the kids working with Paul Rudd in Carrie Coon. I always say Carrie Ann Moss and I screwed up. I think that family dynamic is going to be hopefully be the main part of it, and then having Lucky involved or whatever. And I would imagine when we're talking about, like, I think the B plot is going to be Winston owning the Ghostbusters and having to deal with Walter Peck in the city. Mm-hmm. And then Ray is there next door with the occult, and Venkman shows up for one thing again. Like, I don't think it's going to be a lot of the old guys
showing. Do you think
that
one thing is going to be a showdown with William Atherton again? Do you think they're going to get? Do you think they're going to be that hacky where they're like, oh, he's going to?
Yeah.
This man has no, you know.
Yeah, yeah. He'll insult him somehow, right? Like,
somehow
that thing or whatever.
Yeah, just the scene.
Like, I don't. My thing, like, watching it right is like, I don't like. I shouldn't say like, right? Not knowing context of the movie, yeah. Seeing the guys right here in the suit one time, I'm assuming that's going to be the only time they're in the suit, and it is the big finale here, right? As things have gotten out of hand. Winston, Ray, and Pete have to suit back up to do whatever they're doing at the firehouse there, and then that's it. Leave them there. I don't want them coming to the main conclusion. I don't, you know, Afterlife, You can sit there and be like, oh man, it was so good to see him in the suits. And remember how fucking hokey it was of just like, how are they going to introduce the original Ghostbusters again? Hey, Flat Top.
Hey, we're just
we're here. I'm like, yeah. Oh man, like I love what I'm seeing because I have nostalgia, but this is a really shitty way to do this.
Well, I mean, that's the problem with the movie that I'm looking at right here, right? Is that it's three distinctly different movies that all of which I'd be into, right? You have a Ghostbusters that's centered around a group of kids who are trying to figure out and solve a mystery of what this big phenomenon that's happening in New York. That sounds fun. That's a movie. Then you've got the adults, Paul Rudd, Carrie Coons, Patton Oswalt. I'm like, that's cool. I would watch those three be the Ghostbusters as well. That sounds like a fun movie, them trying to figure it out. And then you've got the senior cast, the original Ghostbusters, three of whom are still alive, that I would watch that movie as well.
See, my thing
but was, I just don't know if all three of those generations are necessarily going to mix because they're three distinctly different movies.
But the glance in what we've seen here, right? Like you're seeing Ray and the jean jacket go down in the elevator with Patton. I think Patton Oswalt's going to have like one scene.
He's the expert on that thing.
And so everybody talks
sure,
about that.
As will, I'm sure, Kumail.
Kumail's going to guide the kids
well.
Or whatever he's doing in the secret.
But it is an interesting, you know, just to fantasize for a second of like a cast of Kumail, Patton Oswalt, Paul Rudd, Carrie Coon, and like, and all of those modern day great, you know, comedic actors potentially taking up the mantle of Ghostbusters. I would want to see that. But my worry is there's four characters there. Who's going to be the focus of this? And is there going to be a focus of this?
Because
they need to commit.
Phoebe, it'll still be centered on her.
We saw her once in this trailer.
No, she had a line. You saw her with the PKE at the end. She's there or whatever.
But, but you see what I'm saying? Like, even in the trailer, it's split between the nine characters that are in this. And if the movie is going to be like that too, it's going to be really hard to have any sort of emotional connection with everyone.
Sure.
Not that you necessarily need that, but you know, for Ghostbusters, there was that originally because it was such a small movie.
Yeah. I also just think like the threat just seems so big.
Yeah.
That is the other problem, right?
You know how I feel about that.
City,
whenever,
world.
Yeah. Whenever there's that big of a thing happening, it starts to feel so like it just starts
to get
loose.
I hate that the world, for these, Nick and Tim, you could talk more to it, but it feels like, yeah, if somebody wants to make a Hollywood blockbuster, it has to be the world's going to end if this thing's going to happen, right? Like, I've always talked about it in a joking fashion of, man, if I was directing it, man, if we were doing another Conjuring movie, I would do at least one day just to shoot from the outside with the Ecto-1 rolled up. Not for the real movie, but for an Easter egg, for the DVD, for whatever. Fun. I've always thought that would be a very fun thing to do with the Ghostbusters of, hey, there is a haunted house you guys need to go investigate. And the whole movie is that haunted house. Yeah. And that ghost. And it's like The Conjuring where it's like, fucking Valak could come out, I guess, and eat everybody's soul, but it's not really about that. It's about them, the demon haunting the family or whatever. I would love to see that kind, and that's not at all a kid's movie, right? I would love to see the Ghostbusters tackle a horror movie and have that kind of thing.
Well, that was sort of the vibe of Afterlife, right? And that's why I think they're really smart when they did that, because they took it out of New York, they put it in the small town.
But again, the world was on the line, right? Gozer was
But the world can, you know, having some eminent threat, yeah, that can be scalable. But the reality is, I think the reason why that movie worked was because it was a group of people who were figuring out this new thing that were set aside from everyone else. There was no help coming to the small town.
Sure.
There was no other people that knew this thing. We're in New York City. This is going to be like, you know, obviously they're going to be the ones.
We're the Avengers. Fair enough.
But I mean, but it does get, you do get to that point where you do want the plot to be slightly smaller.
Yeah.
And I don't mean smaller in terms of peril, but I mean smaller in terms of like, are there really going to be icicles all over the Manhattan? Is that going to be something we want? This doesn't look good.
Oh, I think that looks good.
I don't think it does. I think it looks fake, and I think it looks generic, and I think it looks kind of empty.
But the big thing about it too is, as we watch that, like that's
sorry, that was just for audio listeners. I'm referring to the that shot of the firehouse.
Yeah. I think we're looking there, and that's obviously the finale, right? That's the when everything finally goes.
That's the climax.
Way
right?
Going into the happening. Act. Da da da. Sure. Like the build up to that will be different to get you there.
I don't know. I mean, obviously we'll give it a shot and going in with the vibe that they've cultivated, I think we all have to kind of temper the expectations. Like this is going to be a PG movie, PG-13 maybe. I don't know. But it's going to be fun. It's going to be ensemble characters. Paul Rudd's going to do most of the heavy lifting when it comes to the comedy for every scene. And then they're going to beat the White Walker.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I'm most impressed that the movie's coming out this soon. Like getting a trailer today, I'm even surprised about. This felt like it was like at least 2 years away from where we are. Like,
when did Afterlife come out?
Ben's birth year, so 2021, November 2021, and that was after a bunch of delays. Yeah, and this had been wrapped before the summer, at the summer. Right?
Oh, really?
Yeah, it was originally on the slate to come out in December.
December, I know. Yeah. Which I was like, not a fucking
chance. Not a chance.
You know? But even with how not a chance it was, I'm surprised it's coming out when. March,
spring,
like that's, That's not that much further after December.
Do you think that's potentially because movie studios are like, damn, we're going to need to start speeding everything up here to make some profits for 2024 because of the strikes?
I mean, I don't know that this is their answer to that, but
this movie will do well. I think.
Did you look at
March 29th, 2024 is the release for this one. Cool, what do you need?
That's still a ways.
Look up Ghostbusters Afterlife.
I'm there. What do you need?
The budget or the box office.
I mean, it did well enough to warrant us.
I'm going to twist this to you because you know what you're doing, and I don't use IMDb that way. I just come here and go, is that that person from The Thing? That's that person from The Thing. Good to know.
I mean, it'll be good to see the actor one back in New York again.
New red stripe, too. Oh. They're taking the stripe up all the way to the headlight.
Badass.
Very excited.
Of course you know that.
Of course I do. I know a lot of... Do you want other behind-the-scenes spoilers?
I would love behind-the-scenes spoilers.
Set photos showed slime blowers, so we might have slime blowers back at it.
Oh, that's my least favorite part of Ghostbusters, too.
Really? Ray hoes there. Ray hoes them.
$204 million with the $75 million budget. Granted, pandemic, it was one of the first movies back too, so that's not necessarily the worst thing. But
again, I think it's interesting, and it's going to be. I'm with you, right, Nick? That like I don't always need it to be a world-ending threat, right? Like I don't blah blah blah. What I think part of that though. To try to me not to step into the sidelines, I think, because it can still be a criticism, but it is the hope that they have a new fan base, that Afterlife was their first big Ghostbusters movie, and now they'd like to see that kind of tackled. I said this on Twitter that I found really endearing for me, again, somebody who dresses as a Ghostbuster every fucking year, right? This year out trick-or-treating with Ben, I think it was that I passed 6 different Ghostbusters, not in group, like individually, right? And of them, what was it? It was either 4 or 5 of them were girls, and only one or two little boys. I think it was just one little boy. I think the rest were girls, and they weren't dressed in the 2016 garbage thing. They were dressed like Phoebe Spangler, and they had there was a girl with the glasses and the curly hair, and it was like, oh, that's so awesome that this actually worked. This idea we're making a younger Ghostbusters to introduce the franchise to younger kids. Like,
yeah, but
I was trying to continue with that, I guess.
I appreciate that logic, and you're absolutely right. But at the same time, we all wanted to be Ghostbusters when we watched the first Ghostbusters. And those men were very much in their 30s.
Yeah.
So you don't necessarily need to make the movie about kids to appeal to kids. In fact, I would argue you don't need to do that at all. All you have to do is make a good movie with a compelling plot and a mystery. And hopefully this hasn't.
We'll see.
We will see. Let us know in the comments below what you think about Ghostbusters Tropical Freeze. Until next time, I love you all.
Sell me the jacket!